Peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama. I am a truth terrorist. And I just got something on my Facebook page. Sometimes I can't believe these people out here in the world. I remember I was just talking about how people follow trends, right, on Facebook. Remember I had mentioned about those damn challenges? Well, here's another challenge that was issued here on Facebook. And it says, LA gangs, hashtag bet, kill 100 people in 100 days. And I'm just going to read this story to you because from what I've seen, when they do those challenges, those hashtag bets and things like that, people actually try to carry that shit out. So if your ass is living in LA, watch out. And I believe they're going to probably, if this shit pulls off, guess what? You go have copycats all over the damn country because that's what people do. All right. It's really sad. It is stupid, in my opinion. But it says under the hashtag of 100 days, 100 nights, users on Instagram and Twitter are issuing a stark warning. Two Los Angeles gangs are betting which one can kill 100 people in a gang or innocent within the next 100 days. A law enforcement source confirmed the reports exclusively to the Daily Beast on Monday night. Now, I don't know how viable this Daily Beast is, okay? But I didn't see anywhere on here that it's a one of those, it's not real. You know, those, like the Onion here. It's a fake paper. The stories aren't real. So it doesn't say that this is one of those kind of papers. And if they're doing that, this is the stupidest shit I've ever heard in my damn life. You know, and a lot of these are grown ass men. Okay. And it says that the bet, which follows the death of KP, a member of the Rolling 100 gang, was allegedly made last week. Now, what makes this made this very interesting to me was the advertisement that came right after that statement I just said. It's an advertisement. If you love your family, get a $350,000 life insurance policy for $21 a month. Tap your age, 18 to 25, 26 to 35, 36 to 45, 46 to 55, 56 to 65, 66 to 75, over 75. Then it got calculate your payment. So right after that is this advertisement, people. Okay? Like I said, I'm hoping that this is one of those, I can't think of the name of it, but it's like those papers that aren't real. Those stories that come from those papers, they aren't real. I'm hoping this is it because Lord knows I'm definitely reading it. And it says, gang members say it will remain on for 100 days straight, and innocent people driving between the streets of Western and Nomantic in Los Angeles could be risking their lives over a game on Twitter. Well, I tell you what, don't drive, people in Los Angeles, on those streets between Western and Nomantic. You never know if this shit is real or not, because people aren't dumb enough to do this. They're followers. I told you. You got people that will do this. Not only that, this is an opportunity for people who aren't in the game to kill off some black folk or some Latino folk. It don't say if they're black gang or Latino gang. It doesn't say. I'm going to read on. It says users on social media have tagged images and videos with the hashtag expressing support for the movement, brandishing guns, and firing fighting words. Posts now appear chastising neighboring gangs for participating in blood sport. Now, if they can come and lock your ass up for threatening the police or brandishing a whole lot of money and you owe child support, I know damn well they can go and get these mofos. Don't you think so? I know I do. Then it says, the shooting that kicked off a series of violent crimes throughout the weekend occurred on Thursday evening at about 9:50 p.m. on the 20,000 block of West 99th Street. A woman and two boys, ages 4 and 11, were wounded after a suspect walked up to their car and opened fire. The shooter is at large. The police sources have confirmed that the posts online have been taken very seriously, leading to an increase in officer deployment and other adjustments. For the family of KP, hashtag 100 days, 100 nights is despicable. It's making him look like a bad person. It's not like he started this and got killed behind it. He had no control over what's going on with hashtag 100 days, 100 nights. One of KP's family members, who chose to remain anonymous to protect the family's safety, tells the Daily Beast over the phone. Now, you know, I don't know who would even talk to a paper called the Daily Beast. I'm going to have to go research who the Daily Beast is, because I'm hoping it's not one of those, those pretend newspapers. But anyway, because they didn't talk to the family. But it says, contrary to what is being portrayed on the same social media pushing for the hashtag gang war, KP was a full-time single father dedicated to showing his son a different lifestyle. After the birth of his child, his family says he had turned his life around. While he was still loosely affiliated with the gang, the family says he mostly kept to himself and did not participate in gang activities. He was always in his son's life, from walking him to school in the morning to walking to pick him up from school, says the family member. KP kept his son in sports year-round so he wouldn't follow in his same footsteps, and even coached his youth football game team. His family has started a GoFundMe page, wouldn't you know it, to help pay for a proper burial. Well, why don't they ask some of these 100 day, 100 night mofos who's supposed to be doing this shit on his behalf? Why don't they ask them for some damn money? Okay? His membership. How about that? Why don't you go to the membership? Okay? Well, maybe their membership can donate to GoFundMe. Okay? It says, as the 100 days loom, the neighborhood has taken several calls to action. A civil rights group has planned a community meeting to ask rival gangs to call an immediate ceasefire. With the shootings, I feel like all of this is unnecessary. I can't say for them how they should feel about the situation, whether they should just go about their revenge or not. I just feel like they shouldn't go about it that way, said KP's family member. So, you know, they're saying that you shouldn't be blasting it all on Facebook and shit. You know what I'm saying? 100 days, 100 nights and shit. See, that's what I don't like about these kind of people. You know, if you're going to do some shit, just do it. Don't be blasting it out. I mean, come on. These people are the dumbest folks I ever heard. That's why they get caught. Okay? And trust me, they go catch some of these people. And they go to jail, get beat up, might get killed. Then we'll be doing the fucking Black Lives Matter shit for one of these mofos. Okay? It says, in the past year, Los Angeles has seen a surge in crime after years of decline. Overall, the increase is about 14% than last year. The Los Angeles Police Department's Charlie Beck told the police commissioner in March this year. This past weekend in Los Angeles, the uptick in violent crime was evident and likely tied to hashtag 100 day and 100 nights and 100 nights. The 77th District, which contains some of LA's most dangerous neighborhoods, witnessed 11 people shot. Wow. And then here's a little sidebar here. It says, it's just gonna put them in the same situation. You're either going to die behind this or go to jail behind this. Didn't I just say that? And then black folk will be saying, Black Lives Matter, they just shot another youth. Another youth of color has just been killed by the popo for this shit right here. Teddy bears and liquor bottles and shit all around wherever he got killed at. It's unbelievable. And it says the first occurrence around 4 p.m. on Sunday at the intersection of 81st and Hoover Streets. A suspect drove up to a man in his car and unloaded a round of bullets before fleeing. The victim, 47-year-old Anthony Alonzo Couger, was pronounced dead at the scene. Police are still determining a motive, but sources close to the victim believe it had to do with an argument that took place at a gang member's funeral just a little over a mile away. Seven blocks away, less than an hour after the first shooting, another man in his 40s. Now, these is grown-ass men. These are grown-ass men in their 40s, okay? Now, this guy, he was shot in his car at the intersection of 75th and Figueroa Streets. The victim was able to drive himself to the hospital, but his assailant managed to get away. A little after 9 p.m., authorities found a man in his 20s shot in the stomach at Hyde Park Boulevard and Brenhurst Avenue and rushed him to a hospital. About 35 minutes later, a gunman shot three people who were walking down the street at 47th Street and Butt Long Avenue, less than 4 miles from the last shooting. The victims, two men and one woman, were all taken to a hospital. One is in critical condition. There was also another car-to-car shooting that occurred on... Oh, Etsy. That's something I got on my phone. That's my phone. Okay, I read them from my phone. Okay, shortly after midnight, another car-to-car shooting. It says the victim, a man in his 20s, told police that someone shot at him and wounded him in his buttocks, possibly over road rage. He was taken to a hospital, and the shooter fled the scene, according to LAist. Now, KP's family is pleading for the end of violence. It's just going to put them in the same situation. You are either going to die behind this or go to jail behind this, the family member says. It's not going to make a difference. It's just going to make it worse. Isn't it? The family member got some sense. Yes, it is just going to make it worse. But I'm telling you, you got people who think like this. Seriously. And they think they are justified for going and shooting up 100 people in 100 days. They feel, you know, it's a thrill for them. You know what I'm saying? And they don't think about their own safety in doing something of this nature. They don't even think about that. You know, I mean, you have people out here who really, truly don't give a fuck. Okay, and I don't give a damn how much you try to talk to them, how much you try to appeal to their moral conscience, or anything. They don't give two shits. All they care about is that thrill, that immediate thrill that they're going to get for carrying out something. And then later on, they'll brag about it. And next thing you know, guess what? They'll be locked up and put in jail because they'll probably do a video about that, what they did. They're just that dumb. Okay? So, people, I'm telling you, we got to be vigilant. We got to be careful out here in these streets because you got people who could give a rat's ass about you. You're innocent. They'll give a rat's ass about you or your child or anybody. Okay? That's why I stay away. That's why I stay to myself. Because I know the psychology, I know the mentality, I know these type of people. You know, I've been studying human behavior, you know, not as a professional, but as a layman for a very long time. I've been watching people, okay? And I know that there are certain traits that give me an insight to people's character, okay? Their character. And you can look at from how they dress to how they speak to how you have to take all of those things in consideration when you sizing a motherfucker up. Okay? Because I'm telling you, you got some people that will do some shit. You be like, man, I never would have thought so-and-so would do that. I'd be like, I did. I saw he was capable or she was capable. You know what I'm saying? The signs are always right there for you. You know, but people just have a tendency to ignore it. Oh, because they're the youth or because they're a cousin or uncle or aunt or some shit like that. And I'm like, huh, I notice the trends. Okay. I notice certain things about individuals. I look, I'm on YouTube and Facebook and I watch what people write consistently. I evaluate what they write, and I have an insight to them, their psychology, okay? So I'm telling you, we ain't in no safe world anymore, as if it was safe before, but I think it's a little worse now that we have the proliferation of weapons. It's a little worse, because when I was younger, you know, we would knife a motherfucker or put a switchblade on somebody or something like that. But now, these cowards, they stand back and shoot your ass. They don't fight. They're cowards. They don't put fist to cuff and try to knock a nigga out. They don't do that. They stand back, hands off, and shoot your ass. Okay? Ain't no close contact. That is the sign of cowards. I just have to put that on record, okay? So it's a sad day in L.A. I just got to put that on record. And I hope that all my brethren and sisterin in L.A. are looking out and being careful. Because whether this story is real or not, somebody done put this shit out in the universe, okay? And it can happen. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. Peace, everyone.